Alright, I just wanted to kind of make a sort of quick video. I mean, it's not going to be super quick, but not too in detail on this. I just want to kind of go through my current hi-fi equipment, anyways. You're looking... It's not very well organized. This tower of decks is going to be rearranged a little bit here. So I think I'm going to move the 80s kind of Onkyo and other stuff over to this side. I just kind of have it stacked over here because they were all kind of similar sizes, except for the black one. I had it set up differently, but then acquired more, just kind of stacked on top. So I'm going to rearrange here. But anyways, this is how it is. I don't have a lot of light over here because the light's over there and over there. And then the kitchen light's over here. So we'll start with my main receiver amplifier, which is an Onkyo Integra. Let's see if I can... right here with a little bit of light. There you go, Onkyo Integra. It's a TX-88. It's a really nice one, actually. It is an 80s model, as you can see here. Good input, there's a built-in tuner, of course. It's got a phono input, CD, tape 1, tape 2. The tape 2 I have hooked up to that over there, which we'll talk about. It's got VCR 1 and VCR 2, so it's got a lot of inputs. It's got the presets there, volume, bass, and treble. Control there. You can turn off the system power here, but leave the main power on, which is weird. I always thought. I'm sure there's a reason for that. The speakers here, and then just off. And then there's a remote control sensor there, which I don't have, of course. This is the only piece of equipment out of this whole set that I've not gotten at a thrift store. This one I bought off someone off of Craigslist for about $45 or so. Which is not bad, considering it cost $800 in 1986 or something like that. But sitting above that is my Marantz turntable. It's a TT-155 automatic turntable. It's a semi-automatic, not a full automatic. You still gotta lift the needle and whatnot. But it's a nice turntable here. Get it off its little rusty spot there. Let's get the platter rolling here. It's got the little... what do you call it here? The pitch adjustment kind of lights when they like stay in the center, like the squares stay still. It's like the correct pitch, which is the adjustment right here. So if I turn it that way, I start moving. You just gotta get it just right to control the pitch so that they almost don't move at all. And then here's the speed control, which is a button. And you can see they change there. And then of course, once it hits the end of it, it will move itself back over and place itself back down. And of course, shut her off. And that's my Onkyo, or not Onkyo, that's a Marantz. And like I showed you again, it's a Marantz TT-155. Marantz is a pretty good name in the business. I'm sure this is not their highest end, of course, but it works pretty darn well. It's got good quality. It's got a ground output lead. There's the audio jack and the power. We'll start on the top of the mountain of things over here. This is my Sony, TCR-303 tape deck. It's got both sides play, so you can play one side and then flip the head, and I'll play the other side, like such. It's got control of tape selection for 1, 2, and 4, Dolby C and B, noise reduction, and all that. This is my main recording deck that I use to make mixtapes and other various things with it. Right now we got two unlimited in there, which is related to that case. But yeah, this is the one I mainly use for recording mixtapes onto, which are in the car. That is sitting on top of a Sansui SE300 graphic equalizer. It's pretty nice. Like I said, that's looped into the tape 2. Which controls that, and then there's another tape. I think I got this tape deck connected into here, which you can set with the input on here. So you got another input. So you're not losing the tape 2 over there, so which is nice. But this works really well. You've got equalizer for the left side and the right side, so you can adjust individually. If it doesn't have any way to like set them as the same, you're just gonna use the numbers to like match them on each side, which is not bad. That is sitting on top of another Sony tape deck. See if I can get a little light on that. This one I've tried to clean out as best I can. Still got a little bit of the smudges and stuff. But this one is a 1970s. The only thing that's wrong with it is this little VU meter here is stuck. I have to like take off the cover on the front again and see if I can get it unstuck. But it's got a visual needle VU meter, and it's also got a peak lights, which is kind of neat. It's got Dolby noise reduction, B on this one, because it just says Dolby NR, on or off, or filter off. It's got three different EQ settings and a bias settings. There's also a little metal trim piece, which is in there. I just haven't been able to get it out because I need some sort of glue to glue it back on. But it's in there. I just need to put it there. It's a full Logic thing, so it's pretty nice. And there's no tape in there right now, but you can see the heads and all that come there. But as you can see, everything else works minus that one VU meter. Turn that one off. And then my recent acquisition, this is a Sansui Stereo Receiver 331. Really nice receiver here. I'm trying to like collect more of the 1970s kind of stereo equipment because it's my favorite, because it's absolutely gorgeous, as you can see. I do like the 80s stuff, you know, too, the black kind of finish. Especially this one. This one's metal, so it's really nice. But this, you know, the silver metal trim is, it is pretty. It is pretty darn pretty. It needs new bulbs in here, because I'll turn it on. And you can hear it there slightly. And there's no lights currently in there, but I know there is lights, they're probably burnt. Another neat thing is, you can hear here. It's picking up radio channels, and I don't even have an antenna hooked up to it, which is pretty darn impressive. Oh, apparently you get a Stereo FM. And you can hear how nice it is. Hopefully I don't get any copyright for that, but it's got the speakers. This is how you turn it off, and then speakers A and B. There's another off in there, which is interesting. Bass, treble, balance control, the volume knob here. Hope I showed that incorrect. It's got a loudness button, which it's always better with it on. You can put it on mono. There we go. Got it. But let's see here. It turns it back to mono there, and then this is the tape input here, which I think is a no. It's linked to one of these tape decks. I got too many over here. Okay, yep, this one here. Getting used to this thing, so yeah. That's how you turn the tape. But it's got the selector over here. It's got the phono, FM, AM, and another auxiliary. So that's my acquisition for today. I picked this up at a St. Vinny's thrift store for $5. So pretty fucking rad. And that is sitting on top of my nicest tape deck, but it needs work. It's an Onkyo Integra TA-2056. This thing is all computerized controlled. It's got it can calculate the remaining time on a tape for you automatically. It doesn't just count up, it counts down, which is rad. It will skip tracks, just like some car radios do. It's got an MPX filter, Dolby B and C. It's just really nice. It's got two problems. The speed is too fast, and the source is like messed up. Like it just goes so some capacitor on there is bad. I may be able to get that fixed from my friend. But it's my nicest one. I just need to get a few things fixed, but the quality on the audio is the nicest out of my two Sony tape decks. And it matches with the receiver over there. So I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do with that. Maybe I'll have like two, like a tape deck on just on this receiver here, and then I'll put the other ones on there. I'll figure it out. But that's the ones that are currently hooked up as of right now. I got a couple more. This is something I acquired recently. This is an MCS modular component system. It's a tape deck. It's actually a fairly high-end tape deck. As You see, it's got the big old handles, like it's supposed to be part of like a kind of like a rack kind of deal. It's got nice switches on here. See, it's just a two-head. Good old power switches. The only problem is this one doesn't work. It just sounds, just makes humming sounds when you play. My friend said it sounds like capacitor problems, so we might be able to fix that someday. Did a little bit of research on MCS. It's actually a JCPenney brand, as evident by, distributed by JCPenney Co. on the back. It's got a line in, line out, and then I forget that jack name for cord. But it's fairly nice. Apparently these were actually made by like various hi-fi companies in Japan. This is made in Japan, but it's, if I can get it working, it's supposedly a pretty damn good tape deck, so we'll see if we can get that working. The other piece that is not working in my collection, I actually have more tape decks down in my storage unit in the basement of my apartment, but I'm not going to worry about them. They're not working either. But this is my JVC L-A11 Auto Return Turntable. This little plastic piece doesn't hold up. It's got a nice metal arm. The cartridge needs to be replaced. Can't get it to work because if you look underneath here, the platter, that's part of the belt. The belt is just disintegrated. So it needs some TLC, but it's actually a pretty nice turntable. It's probably nicer than my Marantz. So I'll have to see if I can get it working again today. But not today, but someday we'll say that. Well, that's my current setup. Currently have it just hooked up into this amp. I'm just surprised it's picking up all these channels really well without an antenna even plugged in.
Just amazing. Or maybe I'm not. Remember I said maybe. Let's go to the phone line.
Grab a bit today and see if there's...
Not all the channels, but...
One. In the cardinal order, we're in the top of the fifth.
A fair amount, though. It's picking some in stereo, too, even.
Slash dance and get $50 off your order. That's Helix Link.
Ugh. It's got the like heavy weight feel to it, it's like it'll spin and go for a little while.
Fellas.
Yeah. It's pretty darn rad, if I do say so myself. But that's my current setup. I'm constantly looking for old audio equipment, so stay tuned for more. Hope you guys have a good one. Bye-bye.